It's become a living nightmare. Riverside resident Joe Gable says his 34-year-old son, Aaron Gable, remains in jail in Bangkok, Thailand, but he doesn't belong there. In October, Aaron, a U.S. citizen who married a woman from Thailand, was cleared by a panel of judges in a Thai courtroom. Published reports from Southeast Asia show Gable and his two business partners were originally arrested on suspicion of selling fake passports. When detectives searched their office, they found guns, drugs, and a dead body stuffed into a freezer.
It's just off the chain crazy.
Joe Gable says he's at his wit's end. These file photos show the violent, unsanitary conditions in which Thai inmates live.
He's been exonerated on everything since December, and he cannot get bail out of jail.
This Bangkok newspaper reported one of Gable's business partners was given life in prison, and the other, who was also found not guilty, is out on bail while prosecutors file appeals.
If I drank alcohol like I did 30, 40 years ago, I'd been dead by now, as much pressure as I put on myself. And it's tough.
Gable says Aaron lives in Thailand through a marriage visa. The U.S. State Department told Fox 4 News it can't get involved since Gable is subject to Thai laws.
It was horrifying.
Brian Gann is Aaron's classmate from Oak Park High School and made the trip to Bangkok for that October court appearance.
Just to see him in a box just withering away was real difficult. I actually couldn't even talk to him for like the first 30 minutes because I was just in tears.
Fox 4 News reached out to the Thai government through its embassy in Washington, D.C., but our messages weren't answered.
The hard part is it feels like nobody wants to help. And it's just, if we could just give this the attention that it deserves.
The Gables have started this Facebook page trying to get attention and support for getting Aaron out of jail. Joe Gable says he could likely bribe the Thai courts to release his son, but that would cost thousands of dollars, and he's already mortgaged the family's home to support Aaron's legal fees. Besides, Joe told me there's no sense in it since his son has already been found not guilty. Sean McDowell, Fox 4 News.